Hello all, welcome back to testingtools.co. In this video of Selenium series, we will look at how XPath as a locator is used by Selenium and how it uses XPath to identify the objects and interact with the objects in the web application. Okay, now let's go back to the demo application that we are using to automate, and then I will explain more about it. Okay, so last time we saw that we were able to use ID attribute, name attribute, the locators, right? The ID locator, name locator, and we identified the objects and performed actions like set text and then also click on the button, right? Now we will see if we can use XPath to identify the objects. Okay, what is XPath now? XPath is basically a hierarchy of a structure. Okay, if you see here on the right side, the entire code is looking like a tree structure. It's called the DOM, which I explained earlier also. So if you see here, I can collapse this and it becomes a tree structure, right? So if you see here, in this particular div is also one of the tags used in HTML code to represent, or it is a container basically. It can add any number of elements inside it again. Okay, so there is a div inside, there is a div again. And then I want to go down. There are more divs. Okay, this is a primary header. And this is a menu button. Okay, and then like this. So this is a header. Now, for example, if I want to access this particular select box, for example, okay. Let us first see if it has any ID attribute or name attribute or not. Okay, so in HTML code, ideally if you want to have a drop down like this, right? So this is a drop down where you can select any value in the drop down and then it performs that kind of action. Okay, so for that in HTML they use a tag called select. Now in this I have class name and there is no other thing. Ideally you can use a class name locator and then identify the object, okay? But in this session, we are more looking at how to use a XPath to identify an object, okay? So here in the same window, so click here and then press Control F. Generally what we use for finding things, right? So here you can start typing and then see how the XPath is being used to identify any objects. For example, any XPath will start with 2/ and then here you can give any tag name. For example, I'll give div. We have seen many divs, right? So if you see here, when I give this kind of XPath, it is saying that there are 72 div tags in the entire web page. Okay, so similarly, if I want to go for this drop down, can you pause and think here what should be given instead of div? Just a couple of seconds back, I told you what tag to be used to drop down. So if you are able to remember that, it will be great. Okay, correct. That is select. So that is the tag name used to show a drop down in a web browser. Okay, so if you see here in the entire web page, there is only one select box. So that is why you are getting one. For example, if there are more, right, then it will show those many number of objects. And this is how you, the basic XPath that you provide. Now, if there are more drop downs using select tag, then you have to add more attributes to the XPath so that you can identify the objects clearly. Okay. So here we have many add to cart buttons. So let us look at that maybe. Okay, this is a button tag. So what should I give here? Can you tell me? Yes, it's button. So if you see here, it says 8 buttons are there. Okay. So let us see how many buttons are there. Okay, here it shows only 6. So now if you want to see what are those buttons, you can directly click on these down arrows. Okay, if you see the first one and second one are these things. Okay, the first one is this hamburger icon. Okay, it's a navigation menu icon. Now what is the second one? Click down arrow. Okay, there might be some hidden button that we cannot see. Okay, now let us click again. Now it is showing this add to cart. Okay, now let us click again. So like this, each and every button is getting highlighted here. Okay, so all these are buttons. Now we don't want to click on this particular hamburger button, so we will see how we can identify this particular button here. So let us see if there are any attributes other than the tag name that can be used and provided in the XPath. I will tell you how to provide those attributes in the XPath. So if you see here, it says ID is add to. Okay, so here what you can do is you can open a square bracket and then say @ID equal to. See here, it says there is only one object. This is how you provide an XPath to basically identify any object. So here we are directly identifying the object, so it is looking little simple. Or even you can just go by using the code like by.id. So if you see here, we have been using by.id, and you need not give any XPath here, because if using an ID, if you can uniquely identify an object, ID is the best option to use. Okay, otherwise then we will look for any other locators. So now as we are trying to learn the locators, I am explaining the same thing in XPath format. So if you see here, the same thing what we have done is, we are first saying that it is a button tag, and then it has an attribute called ID, and the value for the ID is this. Okay, so let us see now, like we have seen how to use an ID attribute in XPath and then identify object. Now let us see if there is any other way to basically identify this object in XPath. So here what you can do is, the text that you are seeing there is called add to cart, but in the DOM structure, if you see, it says in the web UI it looks all capital, but in the DOM structure it shows add to cart in small, you know, letters. Okay, now let's see how we have to give it. You will use a square bracket, and there is something called text. It's like a function call, and then you say this, and in single quotes you can give the add to cart. If you see here, it says that there are 6 buttons with the same name. If you remember, if we have not given this XPath, it was showing 8 elements, that is 8 buttons were there. But now you are adding a filter on top of all these buttons by saying that, okay, in all these buttons I want to find only those buttons which has a text attribute of, or the text value, or the value that you are seeing on top of the button. So the moment I give that, you see that it changes from 1 to 6 because there are 6 buttons. Okay, so we can use the XPath in a way to filter between the objects also. Okay, now if you see here, it is still showing the 6 number of, you know, buttons, but I want to click maybe the first button. So can I do anything more so that I can uniquely identify which is belonging, like this particular button is belonging to this particular item? Okay, so for that, this is where the actual XPath advantage comes. Okay, so now if you see here, this button is present inside another div. Okay, and this div is present in another div. Let's go up, still up. So basically the button is present in this top div. So this is a DOM structure that we're talking about, where in each tag you are having individual elements, right? That is why it is becoming like a container, and inside the container there are multiple objects, UI elements. Okay, now we will use this particular structure and then try to form a XPath. Okay, now let us keep this thing aside for now. Okay, I'm saving this. Okay, now let us see if we can identify this particular title itself. Okay, so how will you do? You will say, you will highlight this object, and then you will get the particular tag that has been used in the HTML code to display this particular element. So here we are having div as tag, and the text is Sauce Lamp's backpack. So let me copy that, and then we will first identify the objects. So here, take a second and think, what should be the initial XPath that I have to give in order to identify this object? First thing, you have to give forward slashes, right? And then it is present in which tag? It's present in div tag. So I'll give div. Across the page, there are 72 divs. Now I want to use XPath functionality and then filter the all divs, which will have only the content Sauce Lamp's backpack. Okay, so how will you do that? Similar to how we have done for the button, right? So I can write text is equal to, so how many do you have now? So there is only one div tag which is having this text Sauce Lamp's backpack. So this is the XPath that you will use to identify this particular item title. So for this item, this is the XPath. Now how will we use this to identify the button? Okay, so if you see here, this is present in this particular div. Okay, button is present in the next div. These two divs are basically adjacent to each other in the code, in the HTML code, right? So what you have to do is, from this div you have to first go to the parent div. Okay, so in Selenium there is a way how you can go one level up, saying which tag you want to give. So what we will do is, we will try to go to this particular div first. Okay, in Selenium there is something called ancestor, like our parents, right? Similarly, even in this particular HTML code, the parent div can be identified in the XPath. So how will you do that? You have one forward slash and then say ancestor, and then say colon colon div. When I say like this, it shows all the divs till the top, right? Their parent, and their parent. So all the div parents are identified. That's why you're seeing 10 here. But I want to get the immediate parent, which is div. So I can say 1. Okay, so understand this. We were in this particular div. Now I want to get the ancestor, which is div. So for that we use something called forward slash ancestor colon colon div. But once we give that, it brings all the ancestors which are of type div. But I want only the first ancestor which is of type div. So for that we can use something called with brackets, I'll give 1. So it is the immediate parent. Okay. Now if you see here, this is our first ancestor div. Now we should go into the next div, the one which is present just after this, right? It is a sibling. It is called sibling. For example, if you would consider this as a parent, this particular div, which is saying inventory item description, under that it had two childs, and these two childs are called as siblings, right? Even in your family, if you have your brother or a sister, we call them as a siblings, and that is what you say even in here, right? In this parent div tag, I have two childs and those are siblings. Okay, now we have to go to the sibling div now, because in this div we have the button. Okay, so now you will type one more forward slash and then say following sibling, and then again you give div. Okay, so if you see here, there is only one sibling of div, so it will only give 1. If there are multiple siblings, maybe it will give more. And then you can use the square brackets to identify which sibling, like the first sibling or second sibling or something like that, like how we have done for the parents, like first parent or second parent. So now what we got the div also. Now inside this div we have a button, right? So I will say forward slash button. Okay, so if you see here, we have identified the add to cart in two different ways. One, you're directly giving a button saying text is equal to add to cart. But when you did this, what happened? we got 6 add to cart buttons, but we need to find out only one add to cart button of this particular item, right? So for that we started building an XPath which will help us to identify. So with that, what we have is this long XPath, right? What we're doing, first we are getting the title, a div tag which is having the whatever title you want, and then you went to ancestors, the parents, and then you got the first parent, right? And that is having a sibling which is also div, so we said following sibling, and in that div you have a button, right? So that is what we have given here. So this looks like a tree structure that you have to understand, and you have to understand when to use ancestor or when to use following sibling. There are different things that you can use. Basically, if there are multiple, you can use square brackets to provide a particular index in that, right? So this all helps in understanding how to frame a particular XPath. Okay, now the beauty of this XPath is we have done this particular XPath for the first item. Okay, now if I change this particular text, right, if I change this particular text and then I give for this another title, right, then it will identify the add to cart button of that particular title. Okay, let's go and see. So let us identify this, capture the text. Let me replace it. Okay, and then we will copy this XPath, and when we try to see what will get identified, you will see that the second add to cart button will get highlighted. See here, it is getting only one element button, and it is also to that particular title or the product that you are trying to use. So we will use this XPath to identify the object in the code. So I tried to explain how we can use XPaths and how you can identify different objects. So I hope the content is understandable and valuable. I would request everybody to hit that like button, subscribe button, and then the bell icon so that you will not miss the future videos and you can continue to learn the Selenium. Okay. Thank you so much, and stay tuned. We will continue with the code part of how to identify the object using XPath.